Okay, time to climb up to its head. I'd have to ditch something.
Glad that's over with. Thanks for the help.
What are you doing out here all alone? Where are your men?
I'm not gonna risk their lives. I don't mind putting my worthless ass on the line, but not theirs. Sorry I had to drag you into it.
Don't worry. This is just an average day for me. You know, take down some machines, track some killers.
Right. I'd hate to see a busy morning for you. Ready to get started?
Tell me exactly what happened to Ersa. Start from the beginning.
No one knows for sure. She left in the middle of the night with a few of her best men.
Her best men? But she didn't bring you?
No. I'd been drinking a lot. You know, maybe she thought... damn, I don't know. I couldn't hack it. Search parties. Found their bodies the next day, and the corpses of some Shadow Carja cowards. It was an ambush. The Shadow Carja are animals. They beat her so bad, we can't even show her face before burial.
I'm so sorry, Erd.
Yeah, well, when I find the soldiers who did this, they'll be sorry too.
You don't have any idea why she left in the middle of the night?
No. But it must have been urgent. A message, a report of some new Shadow Carja threat, I don't know.
Why would the Shadow Carja do this?
Because they hate us. And Ersa most of all. She teamed up with Avad to kick their asses out of Meridian. They've been licking their wounds for 2 years, but... they finally found a way to get back at her.
Are you sure you're all right?
Well, I'm sober, so... no.
Well, I'm glad you're thinking straight at least.
Don't get used to it.
All right. Show me where Ersa fell, and I'll do what I can to help.
Come on, follow me.
No space. Why would Ersa come all the way out here?
I don't know. It doesn't make sense.
Is this Shadow Carja territory?
No. They broke the ceasefire as soon as they set foot in the cliff. Almost there. Hey, this is it, where the ambush happened. Our soldiers have been over it, but maybe that fancy artifact of yours can find a clue or something. Please.
It must be Shadow Carja armor.
I need to find the bastards that did this.
These look like drag marks. Did someone leave a body through here?
What do you see there?
This stain forms a line, as if blood dripped off the edge of something, like a cart. See? Cart tracks. I think someone moved the bodies here, then scattered them across the field.
Wait. Are you saying the dead found here were killed somewhere else? But why would the Shadow Carja do that?
At this point, I'm not taking it for granted that the Shadow Carja are responsible.
Of course they were.
Well, let's follow these tracks and find out. There's more to this, and we're gonna figure it out.
These guys aren't Shadow Carja. They're from my tribe, the Asaram.
Is this how your people usually greet each other?
Eyes on me, Lord!
No mercy!
What's that?
I think it's calling in machines. Get ready.
Oh,
Asaram, not Shadow Karja. Looks like I was wrong about everything, as usual. Please, use that second sight of yours. I have to know what really happened.
I'm on it. What are those leather straps? Armor straps. Cut with a knife. And a rock with blood on it. Looks like you could mount some equipment on that thing. There, by the tripod. A used power cell. So much blood. A lot of people died here. A massacre. These look like Vanguard weapons. There's no blood on them. Ersa's men didn't fight back. Those rocks, they're shattered. Something hit these stones. Something I've never seen before.
This is Ersa's helmet. I thought she died in the field below, but must have been here. All this trickery. For what? Feels like it's just to torture me.
I have a theory. But it takes a little imagination.
So far, your theories are better than other people's facts.
All right. I think the Asaram ambushed Ersa and her men with a new weapon. They mounted it on that tripod up there. It fires waves of force, maybe sound. Looks like it cracked the stone there. I think it paralyzes people instead of killing them. It dropped the Vanguard right there. No blood on their weapons. No fight.
But why paralyze them if you're only gonna move them and gut them?
They were trying to hide something. Look here, a bloody rock.
That they used to smash Ursa's face in.
Or someone else's. These leather straps have been cut, as if they took the armor off someone.
That can't be. Her body is lying in state in Meridian. I saw it.
You said she was unrecognizable. Maybe they switched another body into her armor, someone around the same size, and mutilated it enough. So it could have been anyone. Even Ersa. Go back to Meridian. Take another look at that body. If it's really Ersa, of course I'm wrong. But if I'm right...
Then my sister could be alive. I'm going. Meet me back there when you can.
Always the ones you least expect that cause you trouble.
No one goes into the palace without an invitation.
Greetings, Aloy. I am known as Blameless Marad. Please come with me. You're needed for an important consultation.
What do you mean? Where's Erend?
He's inside, attending the Sun King, where we should be without further delay. Follow me, please.
All of these people are here to see the Sun King.
Yes, and each has come to ask a favor of him. Unpleasant, but that's politics. The Sun King is eager to meet you. The machine tamed with a curious eye for detail. It's all very intriguing.
I'm not here to intrigue you.
Too late.
First the Osiram gets special treatment, and now Outlanders from the Sun King.
Passed by some Outlander woman, Ibonics, 2 hours, and this Nora going to the front of the line.
Ignore them. Nobles are like children who whine when they don't get a second helping of dessert.
What's the Sun King like?
The most important thing is what he isn't like. His father. I think you'll find him to be a reasonable man.
Aloy of Venora. She who sees the unseen. Welcome. It would seem you have done me a great service. Erend, tell her what you found.
I checked Ersa's tomb. You were right, Aloy. The body is missing a scar below her right knee. I gave it to Ersa when we were kids, fighting over a toy sword.
If the body is not Ersa's, then we must assume she is still alive. And I will not abandon her.
We only know she was taken, not who took her.
I can help with that. Ersa has an enemy among the Osiron. A warlord named Dervahl.
Impossible. Every clan in the claim has been hunting for him since the liberation. He has to be dead by now.
No other Osiron had the motive and ingenuity to lure Ersa into this trap. I expect to find him lurking somewhere near the border. I've already sent an agent to investigate. He'll be waiting for word from us at the marketplace in Pitchcliff.
I can't move troops to the border without provoking the Osiron. But I could send a few vanguardsmen. And perhaps an exceptionally gifted Nora as well. Erend, Marad, let me discuss it with her privately. I hate to impose further after all you've done, but this is a matter of great importance to me.
It sounds like Ersa means a lot to you.
Without her Osiram vanguard, I would not have been able to liberate Meridian and end my father's brutal reign. Since then, it has been difficult to maintain peace between our tribes. But Ersa has a way of making her people see reason. So you see, I need her back at my side. And quickly.
Who is Dervahl exactly?
To understand Dervahl, you must first understand my father. He truly thought of himself as a sun god. His mind was broken. He believed that blood sacrifice would solve, well, everything. So he raided the other tribes for victims, especially the Osiram. Dervahl fought back. He crafted powerful weapons and rallied his people. My father responded with the ultimate cruelty. He captured Dervahl's wife and daughter and sacrificed them in the Sun Ring.
So, why would Dervahl go to so much trouble to kidnap Ersa?
He felt she betrayed him. She fought by his side until she realized he planned to raise Meridian and butcher its people. And she came to me. Together, we stopped him and liberated the city from my father. Dervahl has spent every moment since trying to get revenge, mostly on the other Osiram who fought with us. He made so many powerful enemies, I thought we'd seen the last of him. I was wrong.
I'd like to ask you something about the Sundom and its politics.
By all means.
What can you tell me about the Shadow Carja? What do they have to do with Ersa?
They are remnants of my father's regime, holding out at the fortress of Sunfall to the west. Like him, they care only for domination, and seek to draw upon the power of the sun by spilling blood in its name. Since Ersa helped me take this city from them, they were perfect scapegoats. Derval knew this, of course, and planned it well.
Your politics seem very complicated. The Oseram are friends, but enemies too?
I couldn't have liberated Meridian without the help of Ersa and her Oseram freebooters. Many of them have settled here. But the Eildermen of the Oseram clans and the Claim have become jealous of their success. So have many Carja nobles. It's a volatile situation, especially given the fact that my father raided the Oseram for years. Ersa helps keep the peace, promising a future based on mutual gain. But some, like Derval, will never let go of their venom.
Quite a place you've got here. You can almost see the little people below the mesa.
You don't approve? Well, I have a secret for you. Neither do I. But we must be patient. Change won't come in a single sunrise.
But will it happen at all, while men live in palaces?
It might. Eventually. If people like you help me bring it about.
They call you a sun god who killed his own father in order to unite the tribes in harmony. Is any of it true?
They say you can see the invisible, split an arrow at 50 paces, and tame machines at a glance. How much of that is true?
It's not too far off.
Well, I would like to unite the tribes in harmony, but you saw how many courtiers I have to deal with first. Maybe next week.
I need to get going.
I know. Well, they say kings should never beg. But please, help me find Ersa.
Who says that?
Murad, for one. Don't hesitate to ask him or Erend if you have further questions.
Jaws like that. You can snap a sword right in half.
surprise here.
Some Nora called machines. Metal children.
This must be Pitchcliff. Murad's agent should be at the marketplace by now.
Sign of Murad's guy. He's had plenty of time to investigate.
We'd better look for him.
Damn right.
Thank you.
know. You Nora could probably make some halfway decent stuff if you learned how to work a
Life in the claim was never easy.
More tracks.
Living here ain't easy.
I think someone followed whoever we're following.
That sounds bad.
Hey.
Has to be Murat's guy. Durval's thugs must have been made him.
Maybe because he found something. Look at this. I think he drew a map with his own blood.
Right. Those kind of maps you know you better follow.
That might be Pitchcliff. He marked a spot to the north. Could be Durval's location.
And my men are waiting outside of town. I'll grab them and meet you there.
Done soon enough. Looks like a sawtooth, but heavily armed. Great. Got it! Looks like they've been chained up.
Durval's a tinker. Probably experiments on them or strips them for parts.
Maybe I can use them to make some trouble. I'll go in first. Hold off until the fighting starts.
All right. We've got your back.
Here we are. I win. Focus. This is your fight.
Almost too easy.
Val says you gotta eat dirt.
Ersa must be in there. We have to get through.
They must use these to protect themselves from that awful sound.
Thank you.
Yerval try to break me. Shows what he knows.
I should have been with you. Why didn't you come for me? I know I'm a useless trunk, but...
No, idiot. I got a message from Derval saying he wanted to parlay. I didn't come for you because I knew it was a trap. I couldn't let you get hurt. Just didn't think it'd be that good a trap. Thought I could take him out. Now listen. Durval's planning something big in Meridian. He said he'd force Avad to watch as the smoke darkens their precious sun. Your king needs you. No more playing around. You're gonna have to grow up fast.
I will. I promise.
You damn well better, little brother.
Ersa. No, no. Please. I won't let you down. I promise.
Erend, I'm so sorry.
You've got to find Derval. But Meridian's a big place.
I'll look through his things. Maybe we can narrow it down. Such a strange device. It's beautifully crafted. What happens when I turn it on? What's Derval learned from all his tinkering? Do I even want to know? Just notes about crafting. And a letter tucked between the pages. Lots of blaze. Headed to Meridian. If we find it, I'll bet we find Derval too. I think I found something that can help. Let's head back to the palace.
Go. I won't be long, but I need to tend to my sister.